We saw that we can add or subtract vectors of the same type to get resultant vectors of the same type. However, when we multiply vectors of the same or different types, we get a new physical quantity which may either a scalar or a vector. Also note that multiplication of scalar with scalar is always a scalar. That makes a sense. For example, if you have taken a work like a 20 joule and another work as a 10 joule. So if you are multiplying, work is a scalar quantity. So 20 into 10, it is a 200 joules. So when you multiply scalar with a scalar, it is always a scalar. It's not a big matter. But when you multiply scalar with a vector, it is always vector. That is the first type. So we are going to discuss in today's session the multiplication of vectors. There are three types of multiplication of vectors. One, when we multiply scalar with a vector, we will get a vector quantity as a result. When we multiply vector with another vector, we get a scalar as a result. And another one is vector and vector, when they are multiplied, the result we will get as a vector. So where, see here, observe here, here vector into vector, here also vector into vector. But the result we are getting in one case as a scalar and in another case we are getting as a vector. So when vector is multiplied with vector and we are getting a scalar quantity, it is called scalar product. And it is also known as dot product, because we are going to put a dot in between when we are multiplying, when we want to show it is a scalar resultant between two vectors. So if you proceed further, when we multiply vector with another vector, then the resultant is as a vector we are getting, then this such kind of multiplication is called as vector product, and this is also called as cross product. So in this lecture, in this video, we are going to discuss only on scalar product, that is dot product. Let us begin. Before we proceed to the scalar product and vector product, let us see how this scalar into vector gives a vector quantity. It is very simple. Scalar means any number you can take. Scalar means any number you can take. For example, if I take 2 over here, and if I multiply with any vector, like take as a vector as a I cap plus 2 j cap plus 3 k cap. So what will be the thing? 2 into I cap, 2 I cap, 2 2s are 4 j cap, then 2 3s are 6 k cap. So even though you multiply 2, which is a scalar, with some vector, you will get the answer as a vector quantity only. So let us proceed to the scalar product. According to the definition, the scalar product or a dot product, you can call scalar product as a dot product also, of two non-zero vectors P and Q is defined as the product of magnitudes of the two vectors and the cosine of the angle theta between the two vectors. The scalar product of P and Q is written as, P and Q are the non-zero vectors, and it is defined as the product of magnitudes. So you can write P, and since it is a dot product, so it is a dot Q, very important, you have to remember, don't forget to keep the dot, is equals to the product of magnitudes of two vectors. How to write magnitude? You are very familiar with the mod of P, mod of Q. The product of, here, the product of the magnitudes of two vectors and the cosine of the angle theta, and it is cos theta. In your book, it is written as P Q cos theta. It is same as this one only, but here I have used mod to show it is a product of magnitudes. They are magnitudes. P, mod P is a magnitude of P vector, and the mod Q is a mod magnitude of vector Q. So let us discuss on this topic. So let us discuss now the characteristic of scalar product. The first characteristic is, scalar product of two vectors is equivalent to the product of magnitude of vectors with the magnitude of the component of the other vector in the direction of the first. Now the thing arises, the scalar product first of all. So I will take two vectors over here. If you see in the diagram, it is a vector P and vector Q originating from O. So the scalar product of them. So I have taken here dot product, that shows that it is a scalar product. Equivalent to the product of magnitude of vector. So I have taken a magnitude of vector as a P. P I have taken as a first vector and Q as a second vector. So magnitude of one of the vector, that is P vector, I am taking, with the magnitude of the component of the other vector. So how to find out the magnitude of component of the other vector in the direction of the first? So for that you have to take the projection. What is projection? See here, if I draw perpendicular from Q to A, so OA is a projection of OQ over here. If I take, this is the theta, this is opposite side, this is hypotenuse, this is adjacent. So how to find out this one? So this is adjacent, so I will take a cos theta over here. So adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So can I write OA is equals to OQ cos theta? If OP is a P vector and OQ is a Q vector, so can I take OA as a OQ is a Q, only magnitude I am taking, Q cos theta. So OA is nothing but Q cos theta. So what is the definition of scalar product? As you have studied here, P dot Q is nothing but PQ cos theta. So I will take PQ cos theta over here. So what I will do, P, I will put Q cos theta in bracket. So what it shows, that what is Q cos theta here? It is nothing but component of Q. See, it is in terms of Q. So component of Q in the direction of P. You can take Q as a first vector and you can take the projection of P over here also. If you take a perpendicular over here, so you can take like that also. So you can write, similarly we can write this one as P dot Q is equals to, I can take Q as a one vector and the product of the another one as magnitude of the component of the other vector in the direction of the first. I have taken Q first over here, so I can take this one as component of P in the direction of Q. So this will also do. So let us see, so one example or one application of this. Take an example, as an example, as we know, work is nothing but, it is a force into displacement. See here, force have a direction, displacement have a direction, means these are vectors, but the product of these vectors with the dot product means it is a scalar product, is nothing but in terms of scalar. The answer is in terms of scalar, where work is a scalar quantity. So let me explain this one. Look at the figure. This is the toy car pulled through a displacement. Yes, the force F is responsible for this is not in the direction of S. Means what I wanted to explain you, that if this is the force applied through a thread or some rope tied to this toy car, the boy or girl pulling this one by holding this thread, but the displacement is taking in the direction of this, which is not in the direction of F. So component of displacement along the direction of F is S cos theta. If you take here, it will, if you want to take the direction of S in direction of F only, so can I write this one as a S cos theta? If you want vice versa, like if you want to consider the force in the direction of S, then can I write this one as F cos theta? So what is, according to the definition of the work done by a force, is a product of force and a displacement. It is a force and a displacement. So in the direction of force. So displacement I want in the direction of force. So displacement I want in the direction of force means I have to take this one as a s cos theta. So can I write this one as f dot s, that is a scalar product of force and displacement? Can I write f s cos theta? Or you can write it is as a f cos theta into s also. According to this, how we took here, see here, we have taken here p q cos theta, and then in the next step I have taken q as a component of p in the direction of q. So this can be written as q p cos theta. The same thing I have applied over here. So I hope I made it clear. Scalar product obeys the commutative law of vector multiplication. I have already explained what is commutative and associative law in maths, how to apply in physics in the previous video. So how to show this, that scalar product obeys commutative law of vector multiplication? According to the definition, can I take this one as p dot q equals to p q cos theta? Okay, so call it as one. So try to understand the figure over here. I have taken p to q as a theta. So if I want to take a theta from q to p, so just imagine if I want to take a theta from q to p, okay, so is it 360 minus theta? Only the pencil mark which I have done, it is nothing but 360 minus theta. The complete angle of circle is 360. So if I remove this one, this will be the 360 minus theta. So can I take, if I consider the similarly according to this figure, if I want to write this one, so if I want to show this is a commutative, so can I take q dot p over here? So it is nothing but q p, and cos theta is not, only it is magnitude you have to take. Cos theta, can I take cos 360 minus theta? Because I am taking from q to p, no? So it is nothing but qp cos 360 minus theta is once again cos theta. So from 1 and 2, what is your conclusion? So it is nothing but p dot q, that is a scalar product of p and q, is nothing but q dot p. So hence it is commutative. Let us go to the third characteristic. Scalar product obeys the distributive law of multiplication. This is also we already studied. What do you mean by distributive law? So if I take P with a scalar product, dot must be shown when you are showing a scalar product over here. So it is any vector addition, if you say. So distributive law means what? You have to open this bracket by multiplying. So what you can write, P dot Q plus P dot R. So this is known as distributive law. So let us take fourth characteristic of scalar product. Special cases of scalar product. We know that the scalar product of two vectors is nothing but magnitude of the vectors and the cos theta, that is PQ cos theta. So what is the special case? What if theta between P and Q becomes zero? So that is the two vectors P and Q, as an example we have taken, become parallel to each other. So they are not making any angle between them. So that means the theta becomes zero. So if you put theta zero in this above expression, P dot Q is equals to P Q cos 0. So what is cos 0? Cos 0 tends to 1. So it becomes P Q. So if it is true, so can I consider that Cartesian coordinates, which is along x axis we take a I cap and along y axis we take a j cap and along a z axis we take a cap. So what we can write,
According to this, if P dot Q become PQ when theta becomes 0, means both the vectors are parallel to each other, that they are not making any angle among them. So what you have to consider thus, so can I take I on another I? So it is a scalar product of I dot I is nothing but 1. As theta becomes 0, so cos theta become 1. So I dot I become 1. So it is same for J dot J, and it is similar for K dot K. So very, very important thing you have to remember over here, that in dot product, if you are taking unit vectors, in case of unit vectors especially, you are talking I dot I, J dot J and K dot K is equals to 1, because I and on another I, so theta becomes 0 over here, so it became 1. So J on another J and K on another K, means in all the cases theta becomes 0, means cos theta is 1, so the product of the unit vector should be 1 over here. Very important thing you have to remember, because we are going to the other characteristic where we are going to use this result. So what will happen if theta become 180? Imagine, no, that P and Q making a no angle means they are parallel. Now P is in this direction and Q is in this direction, means they are anti-parallel. What it is called as anti-parallel. So that is the two vectors which you are considering as an example, P and Q, are anti-parallel. Again, take this definition, P Q is equals to PQ cos, but theta became 180. So what is cos 180? It is a minus 1. So it become minus PQ. So what is your conclusion? When they are making a theta, when two vectors are making a theta with a 180, means they are anti-parallel to each other, magnitude of them will be multiplied with the minus. Take another case where theta become, if theta become 90 degree. That means, what do you mean? That is, the two vectors are perpendicular to each other. Can you say like this? So this is also one of the very important result, where we are going to use this in another characteristic. So what do you mean by this? Take the definition again. PQ equals to PQ cos theta. So cos theta become 90. So what is cos 90? Cos 90 is 0. 0 into anything? 0. So it become 0. So try to understand what I wanted to tell you here. So can I write in, if you want to represent this result in a unit vector, so when they are perpendicular, they are making the magnitude become 0. So if you are taking, who are perpendicular here? I is perpendicular to J. So can I take I dot J? Then J is perpendicular to K, since it is a Cartesian coordinate I have considered, and K is perpendicular to I. So in all the cases, when it is a case of perpendicular, the result will become 0. This is also you have to remember. So how to remember in an easy way? In scalar product, if they are same, the result will be 1. If they are different, whether it is a J dot K or K dot J, K dot I or I dot K, I dot J or J dot I, whatever it may be, when they are different, then it is a 0. Let us go to the another characteristic. If P and Q are equal vectors, what will happen? Then their scalar product will be P dot Q is equals to, what we can write, when we take a scalar product, P dot Q is equals to PQ cos theta. So now what you will take, the magnitude, if I want to consider, only one magnitude if I want to consider. So if P is equals to Q, so can I take this one as a P square? When they are equal, I can substitute in place of Q. P also. So P into P, P square, it became magnitude I am talking. Or you can put in place of P, Q. So what will happen? It become Q square. Scalar product of vectors expressed in terms of rectangular components. What it mean? If any two vectors, if I take, let P, in terms of, if I take a unit vector, so in a Cartesian coordinate, so can I write this one as a Px along with the x-axis? So to show that it is a unit vector I cap, I had to take. And then in terms of in the direction of y, so can I take Py j cap? And then in the direction of z, can I take Pz and k cap? Similarly, I want for a scalar product two vectors. So can I take another vector as a q? Similarly like that. So with along with x-axis, along with the y-axis, and along with the z-axis. Then what do you mean by this? The scalar product. So take the scalar product of these two vectors which we have considered, can be expressed in terms of rectangular components. So what it mean? Rectangular components means only magnitude you have to take Px, Qx, Py, Qy, and then Pz, Qz. Let us prove this. So proof. So take P dot Q equals to. So what is P over here? Px I cap plus Py j cap plus Pz k cap. Then scalar product. Take the other vector Q vector. So it can be taken as Qx I cap, Qy j cap, and then Qz k cap. So I am going to multiply them now. So I will take this one and I'll multiply to the whole bracket. So can I take this one I cap into, so the whole thing I am writing here. I have explained you in a very easy way, this one. Then plus Py j cap I am taking this one, and again I'll multiply with the whole bracket. Plus now Pz k cap is left, so I'll take that also with the again the whole bracket of Q vector. Now what will be if I multiply this one? See here, they are scalar product. If I take this Px Qx, and in bracket I will take this one I dot I. Then similarly you go on multiplying this one Px Qy, then I dot j, then Px Qz, then I dot k cap, I cap dot k cap. Similarly, go continuing this one, multiplying. So it will be Py Qx, then j dot I cap. So Py Qy, j dot j, then Py Qz, j dot k, plus if you write this one Pz Qx, k dot I, then Pz Qy, k dot j, then Pz Qz, k dot k. I have opened all the brackets. Now what it will become? So try to understand. Here are the two results I told you to remember. So if they are same, it is 1. If they are same, it is 1. So I dot A is same, so it became 1 over here. Then J dot J will become 1 over here. And the K dot K will become 1 over here. Now what will happen rest of them? If they are different, I told you I dot J or J dot I, J dot K or K dot J, K dot I and I dot K, they will become 0. Now concentrate on this. It become 1. So 1 into px qx is px qx plus. Now they are different. So it will become 0. So this term will become 0. Here also they are different. So this will become 0. Here also j dot I is there. So it will become 0. But here j dot j will become 1 over here. So 1 into px py, 1 into py qy is py qy plus. Again they are different. So this will become 0. This also becomes 0. This also becomes 0. And according to these two I am talking about. Okay. So what will be the k dot k? It is 1. So you left with pz qz. Hence the proof. So you have to write the reason over here. What reason you are going to write? Since. Better you write reason everywhere where you apply. Since what you have taken 1 1 here. I dot I. J dot J. And then k cap dot k cap is 1. Also what you have taken 0 here. You have also you write I dot j cap is equals to I dot k cap, then j dot I, then j dot k, then k dot I, then k dot j, all you have taken as 0. So this is your proof of this result. Hence we can say that scalar product of two vectors expressed in terms of rectangular component, that is px qx plus py qy and pz qz. So let us go to the last characteristic. Try to understand. If a dot b and a dot c, I am taking two equal vectors here, scalar products, a dot b equals to a dot c, where a vector is not equals to 0. So it is not necessary that b is equals to c. What do you mean by this? See here, using distributive law, we can write, we already studied distributive law. So a dot b minus c I have taken. So what it implies actually? So it implies that either b minus c is equals to 0, or it implies that the vector a is perpendicular to b minus c. Remember, when I am taking a distributive law, when these vectors equal, okay, so a dot b minus c shows that this bracket quantity might be 0. Or you can say A is perpendicular to B minus C, because when they are perpendicular, the result becomes 0. We have already studied in the one of the characteristic of scalar product. Remember, it does not implies. It does not implies. Okay, that B minus C vector is 0. So either it may be 0, or A is perpendicular to this B minus C, or, but remember, it does not necessarily imply that, okay, it does not necessarily imply that B minus C equals to 0. So once you see this expression, I am talking about this expression. Once you see this expression, don't think that this B minus C equals to 0. Don't conclude suddenly that B minus C equals to 0. So remember, it is nothing but it might be 0, or it might be they are perpendicular to each other. That's it. Based on this characteristic, where we represented scalar product of two vectors in terms of rectangular components, so p dot q is nothing but px qx plus py qy plus pz qz. So what you have to remember here, when we are finding any scalar product of any two vectors, so no need to multiply everything over here. What is the intention of proving this? That no need to multiply everything over here. So what you have to consider, only multiply the magnitude of those two vectors, like a px qx, py qy and pz qz, and you will get the result. So let us solve one example based on that result. So let us consider two vectors over here, that is a v1 and v2. Let us find out the scalar product of these two vectors. How to find out scalar product of these two vectors? First write them to show their scalar product by using dot. First you write the whole thing. First you write the scalar product of those to show dot. So I have taken both the vectors over here by using the showing it is a scalar product. So what I have to do according to this, you have to multiply there only the magnitude. So here 1 I cap contain 1 into 3 you take, plus according to this I am talking about 2 into 4 plus 3 into minus 5. So what you can write here, 1 3 is a 3, 2 4 is a 8, and 5 3 is a 15, that is minus 15, plus into minus, minus 15. So what is your answer over here? It is a minus 4. So this is how you have to find out scalar product of two vectors easily.